Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this is a new part of a tiny mini-series about relationship with Jesus Christ. And before I start, as always, of course, this is the Word of God and with this, really, this is going to change your life if you read it. So I always get so enthusiastic when I put the Bible in front of the camera because this has totally changed my life for the better and for the good. So, that being said, today I start with a new tiny series. Today is part one. And I want to talk about the relationship. And because I've heard a lot of people say, well, what is this about, this relationship with Jesus Christ? What do I have to do? Do I need to go to church? Or what does it mean? And we are going to discuss these things during these series. And today, I want to discuss the main purpose of why Jesus Christ went on the cross. And every time I ask people, why do you think that Jesus went on the cross? What is the reason? And 9 out of 10, I always get the same response. And the same response is this. People will always say, well, because of our sin. He died on the cross for our sins, and he died on the cross to be a sacrifice so we can have access to God. And I believe that's not the main purpose. I believe that it is partial truth, and we want the whole truth because the truth will set you free. We need the whole truth, and I believe with all my heart, with all my being, that this is the truth. The main purpose why Jesus went on the cross to get our sins thrown away or get washed from our sins is because of relationship. The main purpose is relationship. That's the reason why. Because sin was in the middle of God and us. And because of this, Jesus went on the cross as a sacrifice so we don't have to live in sin anymore. And we can approach God boldly. We can come to his throne boldly because Jesus Christ has paid the price of our sin. That is amazing, but that's not the main purpose. The main purpose is because out of relationship. And the Bible is also telling that when we choose to live with Christ and when we accept this offer, what he did for us, and out of this relationship, we will receive everlasting life. But what does it mean, everlasting life? Does it mean that I live in this body forever? Thank you, Jesus, for not, because in the end, my body will decay. I will die, and eventually, my soul and my spirit will go to heaven, and I will be one with the Lord in heaven. That's in the afterlife. But in this life, I have also everlasting life. But what does it mean? Well, the Bible explains it in John 17, verse 3. And I will speak it out loud. And this is eternal life, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. This is a saying. This is saying that eternal life is that we can know God and that we can know Jesus Christ. And knowing is not a knowing from, oh, I know the neighbor, or I know the people I know at the supermarket, and the people who help me every day when I go to the store. Not going to the store every day, but you will get the point. But this is what people will. This is what it's all about. It's to know him. It's to know Jesus Christ, and to know him is a Jewish idiom, if I say it correctly in English. And it stands for intercourse, and intercourse is the most intimate thing you can have with a man, or if you are a man, with a woman. So having with Jesus Christ is not that you have intercourse with Jesus Christ, of course, but that you have so an tight relationship that you know him. That you know him and know him and know him. That you know him by heart and that you know him in your soul. That you know him in your spirit and you know him in your body. That's what the main purpose is of the relationship with Jesus Christ. Not to know him, to be acquainted with. Well, Jesus, yeah, I know Jesus. I hope not for you. Because the main thing to have a relationship with Jesus and to have a really tight and close relationship with Jesus is the best thing that can happen to you. Truly it is. He is, for me, he's my best friend. I don't know anybody in the world where I can be myself as with Jesus. And I know that a lot of people will act, oh, I need to act holy, and I need to, or sometimes people, when they pray to Jesus, their voice is sounding strange. They will speak like things, oh, yes, Father, here we are. But I don't believe that is true relationship. True relationship is when you're just being yourself. And you're just being yourself because that's why he went on the cross. He went on the cross to have contact with us, to have communication with us. And that we don't have to be somebody else or trying to be better or trying to act correctly when we are in relationship with Jesus Christ. No, we can just be ourselves. Matter of fact, he wants us to be ourselves. Because when you are yourself, then you are yourself, and then you will have a good relationship, and then Jesus Christ can build you up to become even a better person, to become one in him. So that's it for today. Tomorrow I will start with part 2, and see you tomorrow. Bye.